polyline is an open or closed sequence of connected line or arc segments which is treated as a single entity. Each segment of a polyline can have width that is either constant or tapers over the length of the segment. Polylines can be used as profiles to create 3D models. In this video, we will see the different methods to edit a polyline. Let's start by editing a polyline using the Properties panel. Select the polyline and click on Properties panel in the Tools panel. In the Geometry section, you can see the number of vertices in this polyline and the current vertex. Simply by clicking on these arrows, you can move from one vertex to another. Once you reach on to a desired vertex, you can change the position of that vertex by changing the X and Y coordinate values. I'll change the X coordinate value. And you can also give a starting and ending width for a segment. Starting width is 0, and I'll give an ending width of 10 millimeters. You can also change the bulge of the segment by giving a suitable value. I'll give -0.5 as the bulge value. You can also provide a global width for all the segments. I'll give 10 millimeter as the global width. You can change the elevation of this polyline, which is the height of the polyline from the XY plane. I'll give an elevation of 200 millimeters. Presently, this polyline is closed. You can open this polyline by clicking on the No option in the Miscellaneous section. You can also edit a polyline using the quad. For that, make sure that the quad is active in the status bar. Alternatively, press F12 function key to activate quad. And when you hover the cursor on the entity, you will get the quad menu along with the rollover tips. When you hover the cursor on the quad menu expands and you will get a number of tool tabs. Take the cursor onto the Modify tool tab and you will get number of options to edit a polyline. Click on Add Vertex option to add a new vertex in the cursor location, and you can stretch a vertex to any desired location. Thereby, you can alter the shape of the polyline. Click on Add Bulge to add a bulge on the selected segment, and you can use Remove Bulge to remove the bulge you have added. Use Stretch Vertex option to stretch a vertex to a different location. Click on Remove Segment to remove a polyline segment. You can also stretch a segment using the Stretch Segment option. Hence, each of these options in the quad cursor menu will let you alter the shape of an existing polyline. Using PEdit command, we can edit a polyline. PEdit stands for Polyline Edit, and select the polyline. Then you will get a number of options. Click on Edit Vertices to edit a polyline based on the vertex points. You can see a triangle marker at the starting vertex of the polyline and a next marker in the current vertex. Using the Next Vertex option, you can take the cross marker to the next vertex. And the Previous Vertex option can be used to take the cross marker to the previous vertices. Angle option will let you specify an included angle for a segment. I give -90 as an included angle. And you can see that the curvature of that segment got changed. Break removes segments from the polyline between the two vertices marked with cross marker. First, take the cross marker to the first break point. Suppose if you want to break this portion, take the cross marker to the first break point. Then click on Break option and take the cross marker to the second break point. Enter Go to execute the break. Using Insert Vertex, you can insert a vertex at a desired location in the polyline. Move option will let you move a vertex to a different location. Take the cross marker to the vertex to be moved. Then click on Move option and define a new location for that vertex. The Region option regenerates the polyline showing the current changes. Select option will let you directly select a vertex without using next or previous options. I'll click on this vertex to directly select that vertex. Straighten option straightens the position between two vertices, and it works similar to break. The tangent option will let you edit the tangent direction of that vertex. Width option will let you provide width for the current segment. Click on width and give different values for starting and ending widths. And click on region to update this change. Click on exit to come back to the main options of PEdit command. The open option opens a closed polyline. Then the option changes to close. Click on close to close an open polyline. Fit option creates a smooth curve passing through all the vertices of a polyline. Click on decurve to get the original polyline back. And all the curveless segments will be replaced with straight segments. Exit PEdit, and I'll change the line type of the polyline to dash dot. Give PEdit and select the polyline and click on line type mode. When it is on, the dashes and dots in a line type are applied per segment. Now you can see that each segment in a polyline is showing dashes and dots in the line type. Once it is turned off, it is disabled. Reverse direction will let you reverse the direction of the polyline. Now if you go to edit vertex and click on next, the cross marker is moving in the reverse direction. Taper will let you provide a tapering width for the entire polyline. Width option can be used to provide a uniform width for all the polyline segments. I'll give 0 to bring the width back to 0. Spline option will let you create a spline curve from a polyline. The spline curve will not pass through the vertices of the polyline. Click on decurve to get the original polyline back. A polyline can also be edited using the right-click menu. To get the right-click menu, make sure that the quad is turned off in the status bar. Then select the polyline and right-click. You will get number of options. Click on edit polyline to invoke the PEdit command. Stretch segment will let you stretch a polyline segment to a different location. Remove segment can be used to delete a polyline segment. Add bulge can be used to add a bulge to a polyline segment while seeing the preview, and remove bulge can be used to get rid of this bulge. Add vertex will let you add a new vertex at a desired location. Stretch vertex will allow you to stretch the selected vertex to a different location. Next, let's see the polyline editing using grips. Click on the polyline to get grips. You will get grips at each vertex location on the polyline. You will also get midpoint grips at the midpoints of polyline segments. Just click on a grip at the vertex location to activate it, and when you move the mouse, that particular vertex will get moved. Similarly, click on the midpoint grip to activate it and move the mouse in the desired direction to move the segment. This completes the tutorial on editing polylines using various methods in BricsCAD. Thanks for your time.